Good evening and welcome to the Whisky Lover Society with me, Gert Retief. Definitely not home, doing a little bit of traveling and visiting some friends here in fantastic hot Tanzania. So I've been spending here a couple of days already, so I thought this was a good idea to do a little bit of a whisky review. And of course, as you've seen in the description, we are talking about the Goldlys 12-year-old from Belgium. Well, I did a little bit of a roaming here in the city and went to a couple of shops to see what kind of whiskies do we have on offer. And I must admit, I'm not so sure if I will be buying whiskey in any of these shops. A lot of these shops looked a little bit suspect. Some of the bottles, I was not sure if it's the real whiskey or not. Didn't think it was a good idea to try to take some pictures of these whiskies, so I just let it go. Luckily, I did, as a good Boy Scout, bring my own samples for review. I know some of the countries here in Africa can be a bit dicey when you buy whiskey, so be careful when you come and visit. I know a lot of the whiskies can be faked here, so be warned. If you buy something, make sure that you buy it at a specialist shop and not just at any small shop that sell cheap whiskey or too good to be true whiskey. So tonight it is a Belgian whiskey. Just before I left Belgium, I grabbed some samples, didn't really care what I grabbed. But so this one came up tops today. So quite a nice little golden color. So sometimes it is a little bit difficult to see in the hotel room. Of course, the hotel glass, I did ask at the reception if I can get a nice, maybe a wine glass. Of course, that was not really possible. So it's going to be the glass for the evening. So I did pour a little bit in a glass maybe 20 minutes ago, just to give it the initial nose. And I must say I was a little bit surprised. To be honest, it was not really nice at the initial opening of that small little sample bottle. I was a little bit shocked. Didn't really think it was a good idea to do a review on this. And of course, I give it a little bit of time in the glass, and it's like the light goes on, a little bit of that oxidization took place, and it was a definitely for me a turning point and becoming quite nice on the nose. So this is a 12-year-old. It is from Belgium, like I said, from the Valiers distillery. It is a single malt. It is matured in ex-bourbon cask and then also a further maturation in ex-Pedro Ximenes cask. I also did a review on the Goldlys Family Reserve that was also ex-bourbon cask and ex-sherry cask. So tonight we are looking at the one with the ex-Pedro Ximenes cask and of course bottled at 43% ABV, so there is some chill filtration. They don't say, or I couldn't find any information with regards to coloring, so I've no idea. Unfortunately, I don't have the full bottle. I bought this at my online store in Belgium as a sample, and I paid €4.50 for the sample. So cheapest chips, and I think if you want to buy a full bottle, it will be around 35, 36 euros. Maybe you can find it a little bit cheaper somewhere else. But around that for a 12-year-old, probably not a bad price. Of course, it's all about the nosing and the tasting and to see if we like it or we don't like it. So color-wise, nice light golden color. So if I do add a color to it, it's of course it's not a lot. But cheers on the nose. Now, it has got a nice fragrant nose to it. There's a sweetness. Definitely that Pedro Ximenes sherry is shining through, the lovely dark sweetness of it. But definitely not that raisiny sweet. Oh, for me, it's more of a leather, a tanned leather note coming through with a little bit of a oakiness in it. So you get that woody note, that little bit of a furniture polish note, caramel, definitely quite a lot of vanilla on the nose, a little bit perfumey as well. It's 43% ABV. I don't get a lot of the alcohol, even with a little bit of an agitation. But it's just lovely sweet. Nothing complex. Sweet, and that's that. Definitely not unpleasant. A little bit of an acetone at the end. So I do kind of like it. And as I said, when I open up the bottle, there was that, it was a little bit of a funky note coming out, but it did open up quite nice. So on the taste, cheers. Sweet, Pedro Ximenez. Definitely taste the Pedro Ximenez on it. A little bit of a watered down Pedro Ximenez. Something if you put a little bit of ice in your Pedro Ximenez to get it a little colder, especially in summertime, and it gets watered down from the ice. That's similar taste that you get. Also similar aftertaste. So it's got a nice sweet aftertaste. Alcohol wise, 43%. I didn't get a lot of alcohol on it, but just make sure. A little bit of that woodiness is definitely still there. The sweetness is there. The vanillas are there. That sweetness of the Pedro Ximenez is definitely shining through. And then it just mellows out and it gives you this lovely sweet aftertaste. Just covers the mouth. So quite pleasant actually for something that is maybe 35 euro. It's not really a complex whiskey. And I think if you buy this and try it and you go in with the attitude of it's cheap, I will try it, and if I don't like it, I can give it away to a friend, but give it a go and see if you like it or not. You're not going to break the bank. 35 euros for a 12 year old whiskey, getting very more and more difficult to find a cheap 12 year old whiskey now. I did a little bit of a tour of the duty free shops in Belgium and in Istanbul on my way here. Bloody hell, there's some special release whiskies that are just crazy. And if you want to see some more of that, go look at my Instagram account. I took some pictures and I put it up there, and you'll be astonished if you pay 200 euros for a 16 year old whiskey. For me, that is absolutely just crazy. But go have a look on my Instagram if you want to look at the ridiculous prices for the special releases for 2022. So my thoughts on the Goldlys 12-year-old, I do like it, but be aware, it's nothing special. You're not going to sit for hours and finding all this new nuances and tasting notes and nosing notes on this one. It is what it is. It is a budget whiskey and definitely something that I would recommend that you try. And it just becomes sweeter and sweeter on the nose every time that I go back. So let me know what you think on this budget whiskey. I know that's not everybody's cup of tea. And a lot of people turn their noses up for the budget whiskies. Sometimes us poor people, we need to drink some budget whiskies because we cannot afford this expensive whiskey anymore. So with that, from a nice hot Africa here in Tanzania, and I wish you a fantastic evening, and I see you next time. Cheers.